So guys, this guys, what's up? Welcome back to this new video on Life at Sea. So guys, I just had my lunch. Guess what was in the lunch? It is biryani. I like it so much because I'm a biryani lover. So guys, how many of you like biryani? Let me know in the comment section. So guys, what will you do if there is a sudden power cut in your house? I think you cannot do much except lighting up the candle. If there is no emergency power sources available like a UPS inverter and diesel generator. So like that on board, what happens when there is a sudden power cut or power loss, or the main term is blackout, occurs on board? In this video, I will show you what are the things we do in case of blackout on board. So let's move more faster. So guys, generally on board ship there are 3 to 4 generators, turbine generators and shaft generators to generate electricity on board and to meet the electricity demand on board ship. In spite of all these, there is a chance or there is a possibility of completely power shutdown and blackout that makes the ship completely dead. So in this case, there should be one backup or emergency power supply that can supply to the critical equipments to make the ship alive again. So guys, for that we have this emergency DG room. Here we are near to this emergency DG room, which supplies emergency power in case of blackout on board. So guys, let me give you a small tour that what are the things we have inside this emergency DG room. So guys, this is an emergency generator, and this one is emergency switchboard, and this one is emergency 220 feeder panel, and this is emergency 440 feeder panel, and this one is emergency generator panel. 1, 2, 3, 4 emergency generator starting batteries
capable of 3 consecutive start,
and this is a battery charger for charging these batteries. And guys, this is a diesel oil tank for this generator.
Minimum fuel level in the tank should be 2.8 cubic meter. You can see clearly it's written here, minimum level in the tank 18 hours running at 100% load.
Guys, this is tank level indicator. You just need to press here. It will tell you how much the oil inside this tank. And here we have a quick closing valve to stop the fuel supply in case of there is a fire inside this emergency generator room. And for closing this quick closing valve, we have a handle outside. I will show you later. And these are the tank level switch, low level alarm, and this is a high level alarm. And this is a step down transformer, which step down 440 volt into 220 volts. And this is a dry powder portable fire extinguisher. And this one is a emergency escape breathing device in case of dense smoke inside. If you are not able to breathe, then using this device you can escape this room. So here we have 4 emergency generator starting batteries, and these batteries give supply to this motor. That is a emergency generator starting motor. So guys, usually in case of blackout on board, this emergency generator should start and connect to emergency switchboard within 45 seconds. If there is a chance because of electrical problem or mechanical problem, it doesn't start, then somebody has to come in this room and start this emergency generator manually. So now I'm going to explain that how we start this emergency generator manually. There are two methods to start this generator manually. First one is battery and another one is hydraulic. Now I'm going to explain you the first method, that how we start emergency generator manually with the help of batteries. Guys, to start this generator with the help of batteries, so first we have to come here and press this mode button. Once we press this mode button, it will change over to manual mode. So now it is changed to manual mode. Now you have to press this start button at least for 3 seconds until this generator starts completely. And then you have to monitor the voltage generated by this emergency generator over here. It should be nearby 440 volts. If everything is okay here, then you have to pull this lever out and turn to closed side, and it will close this ACB. After this, this emergency generator will get connected to emergency switchboard and it will start supplying emergency power to the critical equipments. Now there could be a case that this battery got some defect or it is not able to start with the help of battery. Now we have another option, another method, that is hydraulic system. So with the help of hydraulic system also we can start this generator. Now I'm going to explain you the second method, that is hydraulic method. And guys, before starting the emergency generator with the help of hydraulic system, you need to make sure that there is enough hydraulic pressure. So you need to check this pressure gauge and confirm that the pressure should be more than 150 bar. Right now you can see this is nearby 180 bar. So this is more than enough to start this emergency generator at least 3 times. You have to come here. This is fuel solenoid valve. So we have to press this knob inside to activate this fuel solenoid valve. What is the purpose of doing this? Because when we start this emergency generator with the help of battery, then there is electrical signal is coming to this solenoid valve to activate the fuel solenoid valve. But now we have no battery power and we are going to start this generator with hydraulic system. For that reason, we need to activate this solenoid valve manually. So we need to insert this knob inside so that we can open this fuel valve. And after that, here you can see you need to remove this knob. And then we have to pull this red lever all the way down until the generator starts completely. Then you can release. And after starting this generator with the help of hydraulic, same thing, you have to come here and pull this lever out and turn to closed side. Then it will close this ACB and connect emergency generator to emergency switchboard, and it will start supplying all the critical equipments on board. So guys, now I will show you that what are the critical equipments connected to this emergency switchboard and supplied by emergency generator. So in 220 feeder panel, there are some emergency lights on H deck, D deck, and these navigation lights, public address announcement, wheelhouse navigation console, cargo hold smoke detection system, turbine control panel, anti-heeling system, fire detection system, loading computer, GMDSS console, and many more. So on 440 feeder panel, this number 2 steering gear, port side and starboard side, elevator, battery switchboard and control panel for elevator, main air compressor, local firefighting system, turbo generator, group starter panel. So guys, now the question is, what are the maintenance and checks are performed on this emergency generator? So from electrical engineer side, every week we confirm the battery's capacity of these starting batteries and make sure that this charger is working perfectly and charging this battery in a good order. And guys, after testing this emergency generator manually, don't forget to put back this emergency generator in auto, so in case of blackout, this generator should start automatically within 45 seconds. And guys, every month we perform emergency generator load test. For that, what we need to do, we just need to come here. We just need to turn this switch to test mode. And what will happen? After this, what will happen? This emergency generator will start automatically and it will connect to the emergency switchboard and we run it for at least 2 hours to confirm the load test of this emergency generator. And guys, here, this is alternator side and that one is engine side. And guys, this is a foam applicator for firefighting the oil fire. So guys, as soon as this emergency generator starts supplying emergency power to the critical equipments on board, then we can go in engine room and start troubleshooting and try to find the cause for the blackout. The location of this emergency generator is always should be outside the engine room, so that in case of any trouble in engine room, still we will be able to start this emergency generator. So guys, this is very, very important equipment on board, because when the blackout happens in ship, we lost all control from the ship. In this case, there are a lot of problems can occur, like collision and grounding of the vessel. That could be the more worst condition. So that's why all the critical equipments which are very important to control the ship are connected to this emergency switchboard, so that in case of blackout, we are able to supply those critical equipments with the help of this emergency generator, so that we can control the ship in case of any disasters. So guys, I would wrap up this video over here, and let me know in the comment section that how did you like this video. If you find this video informative and knowledgeable, please like and subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon so that you can get the notification of my upcoming videos. And if there is any other topic that you want me to make a video on that, just let me know in the comment section. I will read it and I will definitely try to make a video on that topics. So till then guys, see you, take care yourself, enjoy your life, see you in the next video, bye bye.